to Taskmaster. This is the new Olympics, and I am the flaming torch running through your cities and igniting your passion for tasks. But who are these taskleets throwing themselves into the competition at the direct expense of their dignity? I hear you cry. Well, pipe down! I'll tell you.
Wow.
They are Ardal O'Hanlon, Bridget Christie, Ramsey, Judi and Sophie Juca. And next to me is my assistant. He's consistent, persistent, and his bed has to be water resistant. It's little Alex Horne!
I'll
take that. Right then?
Oh, no, what a week it's been.
Oh, has it?
Nightmare. Awful.
Oh, gosh, what's happened in your week?
Well, I was shopping on the internet, as you know I love to do.
I know you do.
Oh, and I accidentally clicked select all on Amazon. I've got everything. Got everything. Disaster. I've got most of it here. I've got, like, a meat thermometer. I've got lots of stuff. Do you want to see? I've got, like,
yeah,
a Bunsen burner. I've got a one-egg frying pan. Lots of stuff.
What terrifies me about this is you'll have thought of this hilarious joke and then you will have brought in actual things from your home. For want of a more sophisticated response, the guy's a prick. Right, prize task time. Let's crack on.
Yes, I suppose so. And I suppose the category for episode 3 is the item that sounds funniest when you say its name over and over again. OK, so we're going to hear some words said quite a lot, and I, for one, am laughing already. The one that tickles the Taskmaster the most will get 5 points, and at the end of the show, some lucky person will take home 5 items that are funny to say the names of lots of times.
Right. Hello, Sophie.
Hello.
Have you brought in a funny word?
I have brought in some perfectly ordinary tweezers.
Here they are. Here are the tweezers.
Here they are. They're tweezers for the tweezing of a specific avian creature, the pheasant.
Here's a pheasant.
Here's a real pheasant.
Well. Oh. God, they're not how I've imagined them.
Yeah. So they're not actually tweezers, they're actually pheasant pluckers.
Yeah, there are the pheasant pluckers.
Yep, the groan is the correct response. Let's go.
Well, oh, well, you want me to say it? You want me to say it?
The purpose of this task is you've brought in your funny words.
Oh, I thought you were going to say it.
No.
There's a blocker, there's a blocker, there's a blocker! There's a blocker! It's not, there's a blocker!
I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it far more than I thought I was going to. Chris, what's your word?
Wow. I have brought in this. And this is a cookbook.
This is a regional response.
Cookbook.
It is quite good.
I would argue he could bring in most things.
Let's go, Chris.
Cookbook, 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 cookbook.
I don't know whether it's cookbook or whether it's his cheeky Geordie smile. Right, Ardal, what have you brought in?
I've brought in bubbles.
Yes, here they are. Oh, because.
Bubbles, bubbles, bubbles. If you're angry, even you go, bubbles. Like, it's still funny, or it kind of makes you less angry. Or if you're sad, bubbles.
Would you mind going through the full range of emotions while you repeat the word bubbles? Perhaps you could start on angry and work towards joyful.
Let's say you can't find any crisps or something and you kind of, bubbles.
Yeah.
Okay. And then you get morose and your blood sugars go down and bubbles. But it's what it conjures up. I mean, it conjures up children's parties and champagne and hot tubs and, you know, sipping champagne in the hot tub and farting in the hot tub. More bubbles!
Bubbles, bubbles, bubbles! Bubbles. Judy.
Yes.
What thing have you brought in?
I've brought in pickles.
Yes, a jar of pickles. There we go. So it's not a bad prize.
It's not bad
so far.
Who doesn't like a lovely pickle?
Exactly.
Well, I look forward to you repeatedly saying the word pickle.
Pickle, 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 pickle.
Would you mind slowing the
pickle? Miss pickle, 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 pickle. Miss pickle, 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 pickle. Miss I want the pickle, 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 pickle. Surely that gets a damn point or something.
It's got something. It's got something.
Bridget, you've got your work cut out.
Stop, cock.
Yes, she's brought... I think for the first time in TV quiz history, the winner will win a stop, cock. Right. There it is.
I put it to you, Bridget, that you've deliberately chosen a stop, cock, because it's got the word cock in it. And therefore, you've lowered yourself to my level. I want to hear stop cock repeated.
Stop cock, stop cock, stop cock, stop, stop cock, stop.
Babes,
stop,
don't go on your knees.
Sorry, just to diffuse the tension in the room, could we all just say bubbles?
Bubbles! Right, Greg. Points.
I'm sorry, Pleasant Fucker didn't do it for me. Pleasant Fucker. Come on.
She got me. Good, I'm going to have to take her up from bottom place.
Wow.
I'm going to give Sophie 2 points.
Yes, yes.
I'm going to give Cuckoo and Bubbles 3 points each.
OK, so joint third, we have Ardal and Chris.
Pickles got me straight away, but then I feel I was battered down by Stopcock.
Well.
4 points to Stopcock. Pickles was a pure attempt. She takes right. 5.
4 points to Judi.
What's first, Alex?
Well, the cast are going to teach you a lesson, Greg. A history lesson. Ooh.
Hello!
Oh, hello, Judi. Hello, Sophie.
Hello, Alex.
You look nice.
Pardon?
You look nice.
You've never said that before. Thank you.
I've never thought it before.
I'm very good at finding the actual task.
Accurately and emotionally recreate a great moment from history
using these two traffic cones.
Most accurate and emotional recreation wins.
You've got 30 minutes.
Your time starts now.
Oh, my God.
You know your history?
It's just everything that's not now, isn't it?
Something from history.
Joan of Arc, Martin Luther King, or... I'm free.
Ah.
I was thinking about doing the moment from the VMAs. Maybe you'd be Janet Jackson and I'd be Justin Timberlake.
With the malfunction?
Yeah.
That was a big moment.
That was a big moment.
Oh, I've got it.
Ah.
I'm gonna need some props.
Oh, I see what you mean.
Yeah.
History, by your definition, is everything that's not now.
But that's history now. What you just said is as well now.
I mean,
is it everything that's not now?
It's not, no. History is recorded past.
History is recorded past?
Yeah.
OK.
You get prehistory, which is before that.
Prehistoric.
That's why it's called that.
You just learn. You're always learning. Should we crack on and see which emotional parts of history they've decided to represent?
Yeah, I should say it's not the part of history didn't need to be emotional. It's the recreation had to be emotional and accurate, just so we know. All right, well, we're going to start with the oldest person here by quite a bit, so he has a clear advantage from the off. It's Ardal O'Hanlon's recreation. Here we go.
See what's on the radio.
It's a long way to go. It's a long way to go.
Thank you, Ardal. I've learnt a lot.
Thank you.
looked to me like a seven-year-old boy shouting and playing army by himself.
Oh, I mean, you're usually very fair, but on this occasion...
Next, we're going a bit further back in time with Sophie Duker showing off one of her many voices. Here we go.
Daddy, what's that sound? It sounds like the earth is hungry.
I can't hear anything.
Everything smells like eggs, Daddy. What's going on?
Nothing to worry about.
You told me yesterday that the dinosaurs would live forever and ever and ever and never go extinct. Is that true?
That's true.
Very ambitious application of the use of the cones.
Yeah, a lot of digital stuff though. I don't know about the use of the cones. Just had to get that in.
Yes.
Wow. Can I just say? Can I just add? I think that is a fantastic moment, Sophie, from prehistory. I think it's.
Okay. All right. I just.
The man makes a good point, this, and I've only learnt this today.
We only learnt this today.
Yeah. We could debate whether it's history or not for a long time. I'll make a snap decision, fair or not, within minutes. But now let's drill down into the narrative. I enjoyed the SFX, I enjoyed the bubbling lava. The only thing I question is the characters within the piece.
Yeah.
I wonder why your character was, dare I say it, a little irritated.
I didn't want it to be too sad. Because it's, yeah, okay. No, it was very sad, but I mean, like, I think everyone here, whether they're a dinosaur or not, has a fear of going extinct.
I just found with that character, I sort of was glad she was getting made extinct. You heard the drums, it's the end of part one! Where we are time travelling.
We certainly are. Our five comics have been busy recreating moments in history using two traffic cones. Now it's time for a bit of unnatural history with Dr. Chris Ramsey.
Good day. You join me on a historic day for myself and everyone in my field. I'm a scientist from Edinburgh University, and today we finally did it. The first time we've cloned from an adult stomatic cell using nuclear transfer, we have cloned a sheep. This is Dolly the sheep. Didn't name that one, no one gives a shit. This is Dolly the sheep that we have cloned. Have we gone too far? Has science gone too far? Should I be playing God? I don't know.
The cloning of Dolly the sheep.
Because the cones were the same.
Oh, I
identical,
see.
Identical, them.
Yeah, they were. Stuck some cotton wool on them, jobs are good, then.
But I seem to remember that Dolly had a head.
sorry. Are you claiming that your cone looked more like a tank? Than mine looked like a sheep?
I've never seen a cylindrical sheep. I just...
Right. So it was inaccurate, but it was emotional. Is that what we're saying?
He definitely was emotional.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I just don't remember on the task where it said about emotional.
What that statement makes me look forward to yours more than you can imagine. Who's next?
It's time for a bit of Bridget Christie.
It is day three in the capsule. It's quite lonely here, but I'm trying to keep my nerve because if I panic, I don't really have anywhere to go. heart is beating. But, you know, however frightened I get, I keep telling myself that I have just orbited the Earth. And, you know, not many people from my socio-economic background get to orbit a nice ball, let alone Earth. You just need to be brave. I would think of my mother, but I'm a stray, so I don't have mother. My name is Laika, and now I'm ready to die.
Yeah, another one. Just
Street dog, no mother, and sent up to burn.
Is that why you put a pot lid?
That's all I had.
What was the name of the dog? Laika.
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 What did happen to Laika?
It's exactly that. One orbit and then died from the heat.
Oh no, poor Laika. I did Laika.
A fitting tribute.
I'm just a bit, like, overwhelmed with, like how much props and digital stuff everybody else...
Judy, I cannot wait to see yours.
Well, here we go, then. It's the return of the Judi. Judy. What is it?
It's pyramids. I'm an Egyptian queen. And I've built pyramids.
Hey, Julie. Oh, what's your name?
Nefertiti. Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, I can see why you were so vocal during the others.
It's just, it's an emotional thing for me, you know. If you say to me, as a black woman, tell us about your history. I mean, dark road, isn't it?
Do you know who built the pyramids?
They didn't ask about it.
I'm just saying you sort of glamorised slavery there. That's what you...
You wanted emotion, right?
Yeah.
And that... Those two cones up there...
There we go.
..really demonstrated heartache. Like Sophie's just said. And the fact that my art draws the emotion after I've done it with just simple sand and a fucking crown. What else do you need?
I'll tell you what you need, 1 point. And you can thank me for it. Fucking rubbish.
One to Judy, two.
I'm sorry, I wasn't moved by Dolly the Sheep. I'm sorry, Chris, I'm giving you two. Even though it was prehistory and the dinosaur was annoying, I'm giving Sophie 3 points because of the ambition of it and because playing army by himself brought about such an emotional reaction in Ardal.
I cried for you!
I'm giving him 4 points.
4 points to
Ardal. And I'm standing by it. And I don't think anyone will argue with me. 5 sweet points go to the emotional recreation of the loss of Laika the dog. And that's an end to it!
Because Christie gets all five.
Right. Let's have a look at the controversial scoreboard.
Bridget is in the lead with 9 points.
Let's have another one.
And it's good news. It's an annoying task.
Hi, Alex.
Toys.
You like toys?
I do like toys.
Can I... Anything you want to say to me about this task?
No.
Make all... Oh, God. Oh, God. OK.
Make all of these things happen at the same time.
The monsters must be squatting,
The robot must be walking.
The marble must be rolling.
The cradle must be clicking.
The sand must be falling.
The sand must be falling.
The fidget spinner must be spinning.
The candles must be out.
You must applaud when you think you've finished.
Fastest wins.
Time starts now.
Well, I found just the task itself to be irritating.
Yes, yes.
Let's crack on.
Off we go. OK, we're going to start with three of them. A, B, C. Ardal, Bridget and Sophie with a C. Here we go.
OK, so how do you make this guy walk? How do you make him walk?
OK, let me start with this guy. Where's the hole? Okay, stop!
Why were you saying stop?
Because everything was happening that was supposed to.
Have you read the task properly?
I don't know.
Okay, I'm going to sit on these.
Right.
Squatting.
We have three squatters.
It's three squatters.
Two squatters.
You stay, or I'll smash you to pieces. I've not got long left on the candles.
Ow. Flicking. Spinning. Rolling.
I've stopped the clock.
If you don't do this, someone will take my cat. It's these. I hate these.
It's okay. It's all okay.
It seemed to me that the only person who had any kind of system was Sophie. She at least tried to stand on the jumpy-up things.
Yeah, that was clever.
I sense blind panic in you two. You may disagree.
Not at all. I was glad I couldn't do it.
You generated some nice quotes for the Taskmaster quote book. You stay or I'll smash you to pieces. Just imagine if you don't do this, someone will take my cat. Alex asked Ardal why he'd stopped, and he said, and I think I'm quoting here, because everything that was happening like it was supposed to.
And then within minutes of that, he and the robot were both lying on the floor, kicking their legs.
Obviously, there was at least one thing that we didn't manage to get.
Well, there was definitely for you, yes.
Mm. Bridget seemed to find her groove towards the end, though.
It's worth having another look at Bridget, because she was so close. We had to look at it frame by frame at the end. It's whether or not the monster is squatting when everything else is happening.
Click. That's
click.
Click.
Yeah.
It's the blur in
it. But it's up.
It clicked.
It's clicking. Oh, I thought it's the squatter.
It's that blur when it first clicks. It blurs like it's about
the blur.
Bridget, she didn't lie down on the ground at the end.
The blur is weighing so heavy on my mind.
It would be so mean.
No, but it's up to you.
God, the blur! I'm going to allow it.
She's done it!
There it is.
She's done it.
Right! Let's have a break. You're suffocating me. I need to try and work out who I am. There can't be an us until I find me. Surely you understand that?
Yes.
See you in a bit. Who
Before the break, a plate-spinning task had begun. The object is to get seven things happening at the same time. Monsters squatting, robot walking, marble rolling, cradle clicking, sand falling, fidget spinner spinning, and candles snuffed. Bridget is the only one who's done it so far. Now there are only two people left that can do it. It's time for Judi and Chris to look silly with some toys. Here we go.
The candles must be out. So what happens if I blow them out now? They'll be out. So that's one bit done.
How are the marbles supposed to roll? How's the marble supposed to roll? How's the marble supposed to roll?
Oh, I'm not good for it. Okay, you bastards are going last.
Oh, this is ridiculous. This is ridiculous.
This I can do for quite a while because I've got one in the house.
Okay, I think I've got this.
Yeah.
Right, I think I've got this. Oh! I think I've got this.
Yeah. Okay.
Hold on. I've got this. Hold on, I think I've got this. Hold on. Oh, God.
Have you got this?
I think so. Hold on.
Okay. That's 7 o'clock. It's looking good.
I think I had that. I think I've smashed that task, to be honest with you. Thanks,
Fred.
I'm not sure what the face was that you looked up to Alex with at the end, but it was one of great satisfaction, I think.
Daddy?
I think it was a daddy look.
Did I do good, Daddy?
He had to check in.
The little boy
had to check in twice after he'd blown the candles out. And then after he completed everything.
Well, because I was expecting Captain Dickhead here to just keep lighting it again.
Here's my full title, thank you, Chris.
How come Chris's candles didn't relight? Did he just blow them out with his super strong lungs?
No, he got there quick. That's what you could do with those candles. If you blow them out quick enough, they don't get down to the ignition stage.
Oh, really?
He seemed pretty efficient.
Yeah, he did succeed, there's no doubt, in 2 minutes 57.
Wow.
By stark contrast. Judi, are you working on some new catchphrases?
She's really trying.
I think I've got this.
don't forget, how's a marble supposed to roll? How's a marble supposed to roll?
You're in that moment of that pressure. You're in a room, it's all plastic, you think you're going to get chopped up. Like, it's... I think I kind of went into, like, the mum role. Like, do you know what I mean? Cooking, breastfeeding at the same time. Drinking a glass of wine.
Same sentences repeatedly.
Yes, that's what you say to the kids. Sit down.
She applauded after 2 minutes 32, and we have had to slow down the footage again. So it's looking at the candle and again the squatting monster. Looking good.
They're not out.
And that is not a squat.
But.
Ah.
I was the fastest to lose.
You can take that home with you. Good. Let's award some points.
OK, well, Chris and Bridget definitely gets points. It's 4 points to Bridget, 5 to Chris Ramsey. The other three just didn't do the task, so...
So they get 0.
Yes, but we preserved our dignity.
Let's have one more task then, please.
Here we go. It's time to tick something off my bucket list.
Oh, no.
What are you doing?
Something's different. You cut your hair. Is it your suit?
Oh, yeah. It's my special outfit.
I like seeing you in that position, actually.
Enable Alex to bite his duck.
You may not encroach upon the decking.
Fastest wins.
Also, the person who gets Alex the least wet gets a bonus point. Your time starts now.
So you have to be able to bite the duck.
I just want to bite the duck.
Can you tell me how far the duck is in?
The duck's at the bottom of the bucket.
This is like a really filthy task.
You came up with this task, didn't you?
Yeah.
So you dressed yourself in pink.
I don't. Yeah.
You tied yourself up.
Yeah.
And you said that the challenge is to help you to bite your duck.
Well, enable. I went for enable.
What's going on with you? I think you're going through some difficult years.
It is creepy when someone ties themselves up. Acts like they're so tied up, but really they
could
set themselves free.
Up.
Yeah, there were other people, there was the camera crew.
You asked them to tie you up.
Yes.
It's really weird, mate. I think we're going to have a little chat afterwards. Right. Anyway, the challenge is there for these poor people to attempt.
Mm-hmm.
Who's first?
Well, sometimes they're a team, sometimes they all just do the same silly things. It's Judi, it's Sophie, and it's Bridget all at the same time. Here we go.
Is your duck in there?
Yeah, I can see it.
Is it floating?
Not at the moment.
Right, can I use something then? It doesn't say I can't.
How big's your duck?
Below average.
It's fine, Alex. We've got this, babe.
All right. Quite keen to bite my duck.
Can you bite the duck now? No, you can't.
Come forward!
But this is so good. Like, it feels good, doesn't it? Yeah. This is amazing. I'm so happy and proud of you.
Alex, you've got to work with me.
What do you want me to...
Bite it, here.
Hold on.
I should have thought of that much quicker. I'm disappointed in myself. Really am. Did you see how he was really fighting against me? Everybody else, you opened your mouth wide enough. And if you think of it on a scientific level, right?
Ah, good. Right? At last.
Me and Sophie, look at the height difference. How did she reach so far in for him to bite straight away? That shows he wasn't biting for me. I should be leaning. Listen, isn't it? Look at the left. Put your arm out. Put your arm out, girl. Look at that.
So that's a scientific thing, you see.
Very similar techniques from all three.
They were all very logical. All the women, they weren't lured by this. Just a mention of water.
And the bucket and the wellies.
Come on.
Bridget, you fulfilled unknowingly one of Alex's sexual fantasies by turning him into a beekeeper. He bit very hard on that duck.
He did.
Yeah. Bridget enjoyed it as well. You had a big smile on your face while feeding the duck in 1 minute and 1 second.
Wow.
Sophie was 2 minutes 13, Judi 3 minutes 15.
Oh, yeah.
All sub. Like 10 or 4. So we've had 3 good attempts.
Right, that's the end of that part. Bye! Final part of the show. What's left, Alex?
Well, I still want to bite my duck, Greg. So far, Judi, Bridget and Sophie kindly enabled me to do so, but will the boys also help me out? And can they do it faster? And let's not forget, there's a bonus point for the person that gets me the least wet. Here, then, is how Ardal and Chris got on.
Sorry, Alex.
Nothing went in the bucket.
Work quite well.
Yeah.
Is it biteable yet?
Not yet, no, Chris.
I don't want to get you wet, Alex. So, try something like this.
Anywhere?
Not yet.
Nah.
I'm enjoying myself.
You can go and fuck yourself, you can.
Pardon?
That's never going to fill up, is it? There's a hole in that bucket. The question is it coming out faster than it's going in?
I'd say it is going up, but very slowly.
Are you getting close to that duck yet?
I can't see the duck. There's a pipe in the way.
Oh, my God, it's not even on full power, you shit.
Here it comes. Why is the shed getting wet?
There's one out the end of the shed. This is a good hose.
Oh, God. I think plan A again, Alex. I'm really sorry. Sorry, Alex.
Can you see the duck yet, Chris?
Can't see the duck.
He's having a nice time.
Is he?
Yeah.
OK, that's just going to take too long, so I'm just going to knock the bucket over.
Mm-hmm. Now, you've got the duck.
Oh, oh, oh. I thought we'd get there, Alex.
Uh-huh.
OK, see ya.
OK.
He's doing some disgusting things to that duck. Yes! Yes! Wow.
Thank you, Chris.
It's OK. And just because I think the Taskmaster would respect it... I don't even care about the points. This is fucking great. This is therapy.
Chris?
Yeah?
You can go now.
Thanks, mate.
OK.
Stick your duck up your arse.
Oh, Christopher, I've stopped giving bonus points, but I can't tell you what an absolute... how right you were. And how long that jet was. And you know, you've got to share that glory with Ardal, who immediately threw a pan of water at Alex.
Chris was the last person to do the task, and he was the only one who discovered the elaborate hole in the bucket, which went down through a pipe into my wellies.
There we are.
So, do you want to hear some times?
Yes.
OK, well, we know that the fastest person was Bridget, so it's 5 points to Bridget, 4 to Sophie, 3 to Judi. Ardal did it in 14 minutes 37, Chris in 15:38, so just a 1 point. But there is a bonus point for whoever kept me the driest. I would say all three ladies didn't wet me.
So all three ladies get a bonus point?
I think so.
Perfectly acceptable.
All right, so 6 to Bridget, 5 to Sophie, 4 to Judi, 2 to Ardal, and 1 to Chris, and we're done!
No, we're done! Yeah. Right, please make your way to the stage for the final task of the show! Who's going to read it out?
Please, can you read it out, Judi?
Girls. As a team, put one of your faces and one of your legs through the hole. I'm not doing that shit. The taskmaster will guess whether the leg belongs to the face or the other contestant. Most wrong guesses after three rounds wins.
One at a time. One of the team will... a face... So it's three rounds each. The boys are going to go first.
I want the men in the booth.
Men, please go into the booth.
All right.
They're making their way into the booth now. OK. So they're now in. And if you just scream, I'm ready, when you're ready, please.
Quite tricky, because they're quite of similar size.
Well, things. I should make it clear, they are all wearing the same size boot and the same size boiler suit. They are deliberately baggy. They're all size 9 boots, so you can't be looking at that detail.
Thank you.
Ready for the first one?
OK. Right. I'm going to...
Hold on.
You sure you're ready?
Yeah.
OK, well, I'm going to show you the face, of course. There's the little face.
Little Ardal's face.
And the boot, there it is.
It's going to be really hard.
I think that's Ardal's face. but I think it's Chris Ramsey's leg.
I'm now going to ask Chris Ramsey to leave the booth.
Lovely.
OK, please return to your spots.
Thank you.
And it's time for the...
Great work.
..the ladies to enter the booth.
Where is he?
We don't know.
Sorry.
waiting in the booth for the lead. Goodness me, Ardal.
We're ready.
You're ready. Oh, they're ready. They're ready, Greg. Ready. Are you ready to see the face?
Oh, God, am I?
That's Judi Love.
Yep.
But is this Judi Love's leg?
Right. I believe it that it's Judi Love's face, sure. But I do not believe it is Judi Love's leg.
OK, so one at a time. There's one lady not doing anything, definitely. Might be two. But if the definite lady could leave the booth, please, and return to your circle. There they go. Right. I would now ask anyone who's not Judi Love to leave the booth.
Oh! I'm having an absolute shocker.
I can't.
It's like they're pulling a dead body out of there.
OK, ooh. So it's 1-1.
Well, I mean, it's electric.
We've got to do this again. Twice.
Put the boys in the booth.
Boys in the booth.
Boys in the booth.
Close the curtain.
Are you disappointed with yourself, Greg?
No, it was a sort of pleasurable...
Ready. OK, they're ready, Greg. Here's Chris's face, presumably.
Yeah. Okay,
but is this part of Chris Ramsey? Ooh, what an angle.
I mean, it's very clever.
Does that leg belong to that face?
Against my instinct, I'm going to say that leg does belong to that face.
I'm going to ask Ardal O'Hanlon to leave the booth, please.
Fire!
The door is open for the women.
So now I know I must do the opposite to what I actually think.
OK, women. Please go back into the booth. Would you mind?
No. Of course not.
Whose face do you think you're going to see, Greg?
Ready!
Oh, now that the voice has been disguised again, I don't know.
It's Bridget?
Oh. Yes.
But is that Bridget?
I don't believe that's Bridget's leg.
OK, could the spare part please leave?
I still feel confident. I knew it wasn't Sophie's little leg.
OK, if you're not Bridget Christie, please leave the booth.
I should have known with all that. I should have known.
The women can't lose now, but can the men at least get a draw? The final time.
So, basically, we've won?
Yeah.
Well, you might draw if they do it and you don't on the last one. Sorry, yeah. Judi. Yes, you've won.
We're ready!
Oh. Quite quick, this one. Oh, I just trod on something.
I think that's Ardal's foot.
Well, let's see. It's Chris's face. Is that Chris's leg?
Make some noises. Make some weird noises, Ardal.
It's a long way to Tipperary.
It's Ardal's leg.
Well, if you're not Chris Ramsey, please leave the booth. It was Ardal's leg.
See if you can do 3 for 3.
Oh, sorry,
they've beaten you twice, though, Greg.
Yeah, they won't beat me a third time.
We're ready.
Right.
Yeah.
It's Judi again.
Okay.
And there it is, dangling.
I think that is not Judi Love's leg.
As always, I'll ask one of you to leave the booth.
Is it your leg again?
It's my leg, babes.
Send Sophie out, then.
There it is. 3 for 3.
It was. Right, come back down here and we'll see how that's affected the final scores! Welcome back.
Thank you, Greg.
Ladies, you did very well.
Mm-hmm.
The boys deceived me once. I am dictating. The points will be scored thus. 2 points per person per deception.
OK, which means the men get 2 points each.
Correct. Yeah.
The women get 6 points each. In terms of the series, Chris is no longer in the lead. Bridget has stolen that from him because in this episode, she has won by a landslide 9 points. She has 25 in total. Bridget Christie.
Episode 3, please go and gather, then giggle at your amusingly named artifact! We'll do this again soon. In the meantime, let's celebrate tonight's big winner. It's Bridget Christie!